Go over to my man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, every trading day, Steve's got an outstanding show, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, it's very easy to get this newsletter, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right on the right-hand side under Featured Content. You just hit subscribe. You can get Steve's newsletter for $149 for 1 month. You can get it for 6 months for $6.95, which is a savings of $199 or 22%. You can get it for a year for $11.95, which is a savings of almost $600, $593 to be exact, or 33%. Now, they all come, folks, bottom line, you get it for a month. If you like it, great. You just keep getting it. If for some reason it doesn't work for you, guess what? You're going to get your money back. So check it out. It's got a great newsletter, has a huge amount of information out there. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, I want people to know that you and I, we don't speak before I do my segment. We don't speak during the day or anything like that. And so nothing is pre-planned is really the point.
And that's so right. And Steve gave me a present. When you see this, so I don't mean to interrupt, Steve, but wait you hear this. So picture, in between this, folks, I finished the market update. And then all of a sudden, I look at the chart. Go ahead. This is pretty cool, man.
Exactly. So there's only two things I'm going to talk about today. Gold going higher and the market going higher, which basically is your first segment out there. Nothing that you and I planned or anything like that.
I know, man.
Right? Okay. So because I know both you and I are gold bulls here. And so folks should absolutely get your gold report out there because, now this is a bigger picture that we're looking at. Oh, let me actually get the screen out here.
Right.
So this is the bigger picture that we're looking at, folks, which is this is a quarterly time frame chart for gold. And what I show, now, gold is bullish, especially for this larger time frame. And what we have on here, these red lines, those are the quarterly TAS market profile levels. And we've been above the quarterly profile for the last three quarters out here. This suggests that really our next price target, bigger picture here, not with regard to what's going to happen tomorrow or the next day. I can mention something about that, but that we should see price get up to 2103. And when price breaks through that level, that's going to give us our consolidation measured move of equal to or greater than. So 2103, I know you're talking about 2500. I think you're looking at A to B equal CD pattern, but we know that those can extend themselves.
Sure.
So
especially in the gold market. Yeah, right.
Yes, exactly. So I've got a price level about 2932. Now, the reason, folks, why I say you should get the gold report is because I've got a short-term topping signal that should form between today and Wednesday. So it may give you that next best opportunity on a retracement, on a pullback out here. Now, if the market doesn't top and we keep soaring higher, we'll negate this little topping signal. I'm not going to go into that topping signal right now. But really, time is of the essence right now for you to subscribe to Mastering Probability or Tom's Gold Report out there. So I just wanted to throw that out there. I've got gold moving higher for sure, bigger picture out here. So folks really need to prepare for that. The next thing that I wanted to share with folks is at some point in time, the Dow is going to form some type of significant top. And when it does, we should anticipate a pullback to last 2 to 4 years. Now, Tom, this chart here, it's a yearly chart.
Okay.
I take it back to 1896. Actually, on this chart here, for whatever reason, I couldn't get the 1896 data. I think I just simply go back to 1927. What we can take a look at is the red numbers to the downside. What they're measuring is consecutive closes below the close of the prior year out here. And what you'll see is back in 1929, that move lower lasted for about 4 years, number four. The next topping signal that we had out here lasted for a move of about 3 years. That was in 1938 down to 1941. And then what we can see is back here in about the 1972 time frame, we see two time periods where price moved lower before it moved higher. That's where we get the 2 to 4. The next one out here is the high that came in 2000. And in 2000, we saw was a three-year time period. So the 2007 top, by the way, which I don't have an arrow pointed, but there's this red bar right here. That was just simply a one-year, what I would refer to as a knee-jerk type reaction. So when we do get a top out there, we should anticipate a move of 2 to 4 years out here. So how do we know if there's going to be a top? Well, the cool thing is, as I mentioned, this data here goes back to 1896. If we just take a look at the top that formed back in 1929, it formed with what I refer to as a Rhodes momentum indicator signal. I teach subscribers this pattern. So if you'd like to learn this pattern, and I can make the case that you most certainly do, or at least subscribe to Mastering Probability so you know when these type of tops or bottoms form out here, that this top was formed with, so every single bear market since the beginning of data that I've got that goes back to 1896, formed with a Rhodes momentum indicator top. Again, and I won't go through the details of that right now, either with its daily, weekly, or monthly time frame. So here, when we take a look at the 1929 top, this is a monthly Rhodes momentum indicator signal. It's a very specific set of criteria, and that's really cool. So there's the 1929 top. The 2000 top was formed with a Rhodes momentum indicator top out here. That's the black diagonal lines, confirmed with the bearish reversal candle. In this case here was a dark cloud cover. The 2007 top, this again is a monthly time frame chart, another Rhodes momentum indicator signal. The 2020 top was formed with a weekly Rhodes momentum indicator signal. Every bear market that has ever existed has always had either a daily, a weekly, or a monthly topping signal. 1957, there was a bear market. It formed a Rhodes momentum indicator top. It formed a Rhodes momentum indicator bottom as well out there. 1969, bear market top formed with a weekly Rhodes momentum indicator signal. You can see them all out here. This is not anything that I make up, folks. These are automated patterns following my very specific rules out here. And if we fast forward to today, this is how we pull it all together. What we can see is that there's no Rhodes momentum indicator topping signal present for the monthly time frame. I know you mentioned that prices are stretched. Absolutely. Prices being stretched are part of this Rhodes momentum indicator signal. There's not a Rhodes momentum indicator signal present for its weekly time frame. This was data that was captured about an hour ago, so I know that it's current. And here, if we take a look at the daily time frame chart as well, Tom, no Rhodes momentum indicator topping pattern. And every single bear market that has ever formed has had either a daily, a weekly, or a monthly Rhodes momentum indicator top. And that's really what I'm referring to here as that next big major topping signal that we should get, should have this pattern. And when that happens, then we'd be looking at a potential 2 to 4 year move down. And that's really important for folks. So since we don't have that topping signal in place right now, what I can say is what I can share with folks, and much like we took a look at that consolidation pattern for gold, and this is how I pull all that together. Here is the consolidation pattern. It is the white rectangle on this chart here. Although the blue lines, they represent the bottom of the weekly profiles, here we can see that the Dow, or the Dow Equity Future Contract, busted through that consolidation pattern. And as you said, last week was nothing more than a rejection of price. I also have it as a rejection of support in the S&P 500 for its ES Mini, the bottom of its profile. So this suggests to you and I that we should see the Dow complete its measured move. Don't say it's completing it today or anything like that, but should get us up to that 37,363 level. So it takes us back to gold, what we first took a look at, these consolidation patterns. There are beautiful things out here. Another thing that we can look at is the global flow of capital. And that's what this chart or set of charts or data here sets show us. This shows us different instruments, the Dow, DAX, the FTSE, the Shanghai, the Nikkei, the Hang Seng. And in the right-hand column are these under ROC is the rate of change. And this tells us how these markets are trading either in dollars, euros, yen, or pounds out there. And that's how we really want to be able to take a look at market. If we take a look at what took place in the euro, if we just look at currency pairs back from 1995, it was moving lower as our market was moving higher. That is the S&P 500. We have that same thing going on now. The flight of capital is here, folks. We will see some kind of top, but it's not in our foreseeable future right now.
And folks, it's very easy to get his newsletter. And folks, this is the type of information that's in his newsletter every day. Come over to our website at TFNN. Go to featured content. On the right-hand side, you're going to see maximum probability. Steve, thanks so much, man. Have a great one. Safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks, Tom.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.